What is agroforestry? Agroforestry describes regenerative farming practices that intentionally integrate trees, crops, and livestock together in agricultural systems. Farmers and landowners that practice agroforestry plant trees for a variety of reasons. Some plant trees to add wildlife and pollinator habitat to their land. Others want to manage water on the land and prevent runoff into local streams. Some want to add shade for livestock or new income streams to diversify their farm. Whatever your reason for planting trees, there is likely an agroforestry system that can meet your goals for your farm and the land. In this video, we break down 5 agroforestry practices that might be an option for your land. Many of these practices are supported by the USDA Natural Resources Conservation Service, or NRCS, an equal opportunity provider, employer, and lender. Check out your local NRCS office to see which practices are supported in your state. Windbreaks. Windbreaks are strips of trees and shrubs planted along the edges of fields. Dust Bowl era conservation programs have helped make windbreaks a common practice on farms. Windbreaks protect soil against erosion and can protect sensitive crops from wind damage, boosting yield. Windbreaks can also facilitate greater water availability to nearby crops to support yield and can filter and block dust and pesticide drift from neighboring farms. This windbreak at Fields Restored Farm in northern Illinois demonstrates a multi-species design with a combination of fast and slow growing trees, including hybrid poplar, hazelnuts, willow, and several types of evergreens. They also have complementary widths and heights that create thick buffers between the row crops to their north and specialty crops to the south. Windbreaks may require farmers to take land out of commodity crop production, but incorporating tree and shrub crops into a windbreak design can add additional income opportunities to help offset loss in acreage. Riparian forest buffers. Riparian forest buffers are trees and shrubs planted alongside a stream, lake, or wetland. The trees help slow runoff from the fields and stabilize the soil during heavy rains and flooding. The root systems filter nutrients before they enter into the waterway, protecting clean drinking water and fishing for communities downstream. At Lily Springs Farm in western Wisconsin, the trees, shrubs, and herbs planted along waterways play an important role in filtering water runoff before it enters the Greater St. Croix watershed, which feeds into the Mississippi River. Tree canopies along waterways keep water temperatures cool for fish, and branches that fall into the water create wildlife habitat for amphibians. If buffers are planted with nut or berry shrubs, for example, farmers could benefit from additional income potential to marginal cropland. Alternatively, some farmers choose to take productive cropland out of production to extend riparian buffers and add wildlife habitat for birds and pollinators to their land. Silvopasture. Silvopasture is the integrated management of livestock, forages, and woody crops. In silvopasture systems, livestock consume forages grown beneath tree crops, and in some cases the fruit, nuts, or leaves of the woody plants as well. Silvopasture systems should always utilize managed rotational grazing practices to reduce pressure on the land and trees. Well-managed livestock can be vital to making farms function as healthy ecosystems. They help clear weeds, control insects and pests, and spread and cycle nutrients through excretion. In return, trees can provide shade and shelter for animals, reducing the stress of extreme temperatures. Silvopasture can be established by adding trees to a pasture or by removing unwanted trees from a wooded area and establishing forage species. These two establishment methods vary significantly, and NRCS funding primarily supports the addition of trees to pasture. At All Seasons Farm, a grass-fed organic dairy in Wisconsin's driftless area, trees planted in pasture serve as paddocks for livestock that graze in the system. The trees will provide shade for animals in the hot summers and extra feed that can boost yields, Silvopasture also adds an option to harvest timber, fruit, or nuts from the tree crops, providing an extra income opportunity for farmers. Harvesting fruit or nuts from a silvopasture system requires added attention to food safety. Common sense practices, such as not allowing livestock into the area until after fruit or nuts have been harvested, reduces risk of food contamination. Alley cropping. Alley cropping is the cultivation of crops in between widely spaced rows of trees or shrubs. Their deep perennial roots capture nutrients that shallow annual crop roots cannot, increasing the productive potential of the agricultural system. At Hudson Farm in central Illinois, 60 acres of conventional corn and soybean production is alley cropped with five native timber species planted in both one row and three row blocks in field. The widely spaced rows are carefully designed to accommodate farm equipment and implements that move throughout the field during the growing season. Alley cropping with timber, fruit, or nut trees can add income streams to diversify farm revenue and build long-term resilience for the operation. Plus, trees reduce wind stress on crops, stabilize crop temperatures, and regenerate soil, which can boost yield. Alley cropping can add complexity to a farm and, like most agroforestry, requires long-term access to land to realize the full benefits of the investment. Food forests, or forest farming. In a food forest, trees of different sizes produce nuts and fruit while shade-tolerant crops are grown under their canopy. These dense, multi-story plantings can be established on public or private land for a neighborhood or family to share. Local harvests increase access to fresh food in your community, and NRCS may offer financial assistance for establishing new food forest plantings. Check with your local NRCS office for details. Farming under existing tree canopy is done without major disturbance and can provide additional income in forests typically just managed for timber. Cultivating mushrooms or harvesting herbs or medicinal plants are common forest farming practices. At Green Pastures Farm in Missouri, shiitake mushrooms grow under tree canopies in tree limbs cut from the forest, adding an income option for people with forested land. If you want to learn more about planting trees in an agroforestry system on your land, visit savannainstitute.org for farm planning resources.